chapter-wise list of all my videos is available at this point. For DVD, pen drive, please write an email to me. These videos, they do not require internet, they play offline, there is no problem of buffering. And please subscribe to my channel for regular updates. Thank you for your support once again. In this session, we shall take up the questions that have been asked in the previous years. We shall take 10 questions one by one. So let us start with our first question. When x cube minus 2x square plus px minus q is divided by x square minus 2x minus 3, the remainder is x minus 6. What are the values of p and q? These all questions, they are based on the concepts of the remainder theorem and the factor theorem. Now here at the outset, I want to tell you that these theorems are end results in one way. They give some end point to us, which we have already discussed in the previous lectures. They may not exactly fit into the requirements of every question. So why I am saying that? I'll show it with a sort of a diagram. Suppose this is the end point at which a theorem takes us, the final conclusion. To reach this conclusion, we pass through a proof which has a number of steps and a thought pattern. The examiner may or may not ask a question out of the end result, but he can weave or make a question out of the steps that are shown through the proof. The steps that one will take to prove this endpoint, an examiner can ask a question from anything in between here. That is why I've spent the previous three parts, this is the fourth part now, the previous three parts on proving the remainder theorem and the factor theorem, and I took all the steps of the proof one by one there. So this question, at the face of it, it looks like that it is a direct application of the remainder theorem. But it is not a direct application of the remainder theorem, because the remainder theorem will apply to the case when one polynomial is divided by a linear polynomial. But in this case, the division is by a quadratic polynomial. So factor theorem, that is this endpoint, may not apply, but the proof that took us to the factor theorem or the proof that took us to the remainder theorem, they are actually the same face of the same coin. These steps during that proof will be helpful to us here at this point. One of the things that I discussed during those proofs was long division. This question is actually a direct application of long division. Now I will quickly take you through the long division here, which I have explained in full detail probably in part 1 of the series. This is part 4. I have discussed that in part 1. So let us reproduce that to see how we can get a solution to this equation. Here he says x cube minus 2x square plus px minus q. This has to be put inside. It is the dividend. So it is divided by this x square minus 2x minus 3. Okay. When this division is carried out, the remainder that is left is x minus 6. Let us now perform the division in a long way to see whether we can get some endpoint, we can get some help out of that. So let us proceed. This is x square and this is x cube. As usual, we have to find out a polynomial which when multiplied to x square should give x cube. So that we can subtract that out and remove this, and our division continues. So what is that? We can observe that we'll have to put x here, because x square into x will give me x cube. Then this x when multiplied by minus 2x, it will give me minus 2x square. And when this x is multiplied by minus 3, it gives me minus 3x. This is what I get after the first step of my division. I had to take to this long division because the remainder theorem was not directly applicable to this case. Remainder theorem is directly applicable only when you have the divisor as the linear polynomial, but here the divisor was a quadratic. Now let us do the subtraction of the lower term, change the signs. This changes to plus, this also changes to plus. Now with this changed signs, I'll perform an addition there because it will help me out. X cube plus my plus added to x minus x cube, this will actually cancel it out. Minus 2x square and 2x square will also cancel out because this is minus, this is plus. What about this term? It will give me plus 3 plus p. So I can write it as p plus 3 into x and bring that q down. So this is what I am at the end of the first step. Now we observe that the degree of the remainder is 1 and the degree of the divisor is 2. So we cannot move any further with the division because the degree of the remainder has already been reduced to lower than the degree of this quadratic. Therefore, this will be the end point of this division. Now, according to our long division, the answer is this. And the remainder given in the question is x minus 6. So the two have to be exactly equal, so I write it as x minus 6. Now let us compare the coefficients of x on this side to this side. So we can see that p plus 3 will be equal to 1 because x is multiplied to 1 here and x is multiplied to p plus 3. And we can immediately take the implication. It is implied that p will be equal to, take 3 to the other side, 1 minus 3, which is equal to minus 2. We have got the value of p, and likewise, let us make a comparison of the constant terms. These constant terms will be minus q should be equal to minus 6. The minus on both the sides can be removed, so we can write q is equal to 6. This is the answer. This is q and this is p. So you can see how we thought logically. We ruled out that remainder theorem cannot be directly used in this step 1. And then we took to long division, and the long division took us to the remainder. And you also see how I used each and every concept that I learned during the proofs of the remainder and the factor theorems. There we learned that the division stops when the degree of the remainder falls below the degree of the dividend of the divisor. Let us now proceed on to our next question. Here he says, what is x if y minus 2 is a factor of this? So in this case, we can immediately see that factor theorem can be used because factor and remainder theorems, they will be useful when one of the things is a linear polynomial, like we have a linear polynomial y minus 2. So y minus 2 is a factor of this. This is what we have been given in this case. Let us recall the factor theorem. Factor theorem says that a polynomial px has x minus a as its factor if PA is equal to 0. This is what is given to us by the factor theorem. Now, in this case, the polynomial is y square and this is also y. So, we will have to write PY equal to y square plus 3xy minus 2x. And y minus 2, that is y minus a, will be a factor of py if p at a, now a is what, 2, minus 2 minus a, so a is a 2, if p2 is equal to 0. So which implies, now put y equal to 2 in equation 1. So we can put y equal to 2 in equation 1. So we get 2 square plus 3x into 2 minus 2x equal to 0. This should be 0. Let us recheck 2 square plus 3x into 2 minus 2x, because x is just a placeholder. We don't have to worry about x. We have to only concentrate on y, because here it is y and here it is also an expression in y. So the rest is mathematics. 2 square 4 plus 6x minus 2x equal to 0, which implies this 4, keep it like this. 6x minus 2x will be 4x equal to 0, which implies 4x is equal to, take this 4 to the other side, becomes minus 4, and which implies x is equal to minus 4 by 4 is equal to minus 1 is the answer. So this was a simple application of the factor theorem. The only thing that you could have been confused was that we are very much used to seeing x as a variable, but in this case the question has y as the variable. So this was the only trick point in this. So you should be clear about the concepts. If z is used here and z is involved here, then you have to look at it from the perspective of z. If x is here and x is here, then we look it at from the perspective of x. Let us now move on to our next question. What is the remainder when x raised to the power 11 plus 1 is divided by x plus 1? Of course, we don't have to do long division. We have to use the remainder theorem only, because this is the remainder is a word used here. And one of the polynomials is a linear polynomial. Let us recall the remainder theorem. If px is divided by x minus a, the remainder is the value of p at x equal to a. This is what we know from the remainder theorem. Now we will see a direct application in this case. So we can write px as x to the power 11 plus 1 and the remainder when px is divided, when px is divided by x plus 1, that is by x minus 1. I brought this x plus 1 into the format x minus a. So I have used plus as minus minus 1, so that my a will be minus 1 in this case. The remainder when px is divided by x plus 1, that is x minus minus 1, will be equal to p minus 1, because a is minus 1 in this case. So we will write it as 11, p minus 1. So we will put here x equal to minus 1. Minus 1 raised to the power 11 plus 1. So which is equal to minus 1 raised to the power odd number multiply minus 1 3 times multiplied 5 times. The answer will always be minus 1. So add this 1, it will give me 0 as the answer. So we are seeing how the previous year's question papers can be easily solved by a knowledge of the remainder theorem, by the knowledge of the factor theorem. Let us move on to our next question.